Wisdom from sense of eternity. Wisdom from sense of eternity. Very often people ask how to treat the spiritual path. You cannot do this directly because there is nothing like a spiritual path. As you traverse along life's roads, you create a thoroughfare that will lead you, and you are not choosing anything. You will be surprised that if you do not choose, instead you remain in a choiceless awareness, your life will start expressing something which is beyond both positive and negative. In fact, it is higher than both. So you are not going to be a loser. It is not going to be negative. Also, it is not going to be positive either. Instead, it is going to be existential. When I say you need nothing else to do except be creative in whatever you do, this is not understood. What is creativity? Creativity is the fragrance of your inner harmony and oneness. It is the way to connect to your inner space and no mind. And when there is harmony within and oneness, existence manifests through you as a creative force. Creativity is the way God interacts with the cosmos. And when you start interacting with your surroundings, works, and with small things out of joy, harmony, creativity naturally happens. So this alone is the way. For this, you have to work both with body and the mind simultaneously. The body should be trained through various methodologies, maybe of yogic exercise, and mind through awareness. Because various postures and gestures create something rhythmic within the body. You look at the dancer. Dancer makes various hand movements, the movements of the eyes. Through the eyes expresses many things that cannot be expressed through the words. And dance is one of the most beautiful aspects of knowing the subtle ways of expressing yourself. If you are interested in something else other than dance, maybe music, maybe any other art form, in a subtle way, you express yourself, you express your inner joy, you express your harmony, you express your oneness in myriad mystical ways and mind through awareness. You will require more awareness. You will require more awareness if you practice yoga, because the moment you start practicing the subtle movements of the body, eyes, hands, you will require more practice. If you are angry, you can ordinarily become aware of it because it is gross. But if you practice breathing techniques, you will need more awareness and more sensitivity to be aware of your anger, because now anger will become more subtle. The body is not cooperating with it, so there will be no physical expression of it at all. You will remain mentally angry. Your musculature will become that of anger. So one has to be much more careful and aware in this process. You are the center, but you are not aware of this. Your connection is only of the circumference. We see things around us. We interact with people, animate inanimate objects, but our connection is only on the surface. We have methodology. For instance, you are cooking something. For this, you require certain ingredients. Are you in harmony with those ingredients or not? Each ingredient has a different technique. The more meditative, the more creative you are, you will be able to blend these in a unique way. For instance, when Hindus do the fasting during 9 days of the goddess, the 9 goddesses are nothing else but 9 doors to enter oneself. There is nothing Hinduism except the name in it. It is very scientific. These are the 2 periods, the equinox. When sun along its movement on its path and earth movement on its path, they overlap. It comes in the beginning of the year when winter is giving way to spring. The other when autumn is coming to an end and winter is approaching. These are the 2 times when the physical energy is at its lowest ebb. You are susceptible to many kinds of diseases, virus and infections, physical ailments. So it has been designed 9 days period of fasting and they associated it with rituals. These 9 goddesses are nothing else, that is the physical aspect. But the actual manifestation for the benefit of humanity, it is 9 herbs. The first day, it is celebrated as the daughter of the mountain called Shalputri. Shal means mountain, Putri means daughter. And its physical manifestation is a herb that is used very widely in Ayurvedic called Harh. The second day is dedicated to Brahmacharini Devi. This comes from the word Brahmi. Brahmi is Ashwagandha. That herb which enhances the memory and gives tremendous power to an individual. So during this period, specific kinds of foods are necessary to be eaten. For instance, we use iodized salt, but the seas are polluted. Instead of that, you can start using the Himalayan rock salt, white, pink, orange. These are the different hues of it are available. They are rich with 84 different minerals and vitamins. Carries tremendous energy, but it is not free from iodine. Now, when you use aloes in your day-to-day life, you know the qualities of aloes. Aloes is a rich source of iodine. This is, you are connected to aloes not as an ugly root vegetable, instead you are connected to its center. Another root vegetable is sweet potato. Human body requires 22 different minerals and vitamins. Out of these, 14 are produced by the body itself. Remainder of 8 are to be provided from outside sources, and 6 of these vitamins and minerals are found in sweet potato. This is the way you are connecting to all that is around you to its center. When the 2 centers unite, there is a harmony. And then whatever you are doing, whatever you are creating is an aspect of creativity. And creativity is the greatest quality of God. It is said God is creator. This is the way you are connecting to your center. And first you are connected to your center, and then through that you will be able to connect to the center of all that surrounds you, whether it is animate or inanimate, whether you are dealing with your children, husband, wife, friends or anyone else. But your connection is only of the circumference. All relations, emotions and all that is changing relates to periphery. Your moods keep on changing. The way you relate to a person is a dynamic process. It never remains the same. You go to a river and take a bath. River is not stationary. Do you know, have you ever introspected what a river is? River has two banks which create a bed between the two banks. So two banks and the bed, are these the river? No, they create the physical aspect of the river. And between the two banks on the river bed, water flows. All this comprises something that we call a river. But river is a constant flow. If it is not a flow, then it cannot be called a river. Then it is called a pond. There is a difference. River has a flow, pond does not have a flow. The water remains in a specific space without any movement. There is no circulation of the water. When we use various decorative pieces as waterfall in our compound, water continues to flow. It does not matter how far it travels in the process of flowing. And that flow is very important. It is connected with the flow in life, flow in relations, flow in everything. Deep within, at the center, we are all connected. We are only separate on the surface or on the periphery. At the center, we are one. On the periphery, we are individuals and personalities. At the center, we are the essence of the cosmos. We are one. And when sometimes you are at the center, you can have all those glimpses which happen to anybody who is at the center. This is what happens when a master, you sit in the company of a sheikh or a master, he looks at your center and you feel a different kind of connectivity which you do not feel otherwise. At some time or the other, even for a few moments, everyone moves to the center. Indeed, in spite of oneself, sometimes one reaches the center, whether it is in a state of unconscious or in a state of consciousness. Usually it happens in a state of unconsciousness. You are sleeping and all of a sudden in sleep for a few moments you reach to your center. And that is what we call a sound sleep. When we get up after that, we feel rejuvenated. You may not be able to express it sometimes, or maybe your expression is not adequate because the expression belongs to the periphery and the experience belongs to the center. When you are at the center, you experience something, and when you come back to the periphery, you may not be able to express it, or may be able to express it inadequately. Sometimes somebody else may be able to express it in a better way. Listening to him, suddenly you will see, but this is what I was going to say, or this is what I have been feeling. A master, a sheikh, is the whole universe in a microform. He is aware of it. You are also that, but you are not aware. He is the pulse of the cosmos. He breathes with existence. And when he breathes, the entire existence breathes with him. If you can learn how to inhale with the master and how to exhale too, if you can learn simply that, you have learned all. To breathe with the master is the only way of transformation. I was listening to the interview of one of the actors, Nasruddin Shah, the Indian actor, who played the part of Mirza Ghalib in the movie, in the serial that was made by Gulzar. Nasruddin Shah is an excellent ace actor, but he does not have the voice of a singer. So the voice of Jagjit Singh was taken as a background and Nasruddin Shah was to act on that. He said in his interview, he inhaled Jagjit Singh. He matched his breathing with that of Jagjit Singh as the words are emerging. Now I am speaking to you. Moment there is a pause. During that pause, I exhale. Then I inhale, a sentence is formed. And this process continues while I am speaking. I am speaking on the surface. The words are happening on the surface. But deep within, a process is happening, the inhaling and exhaling. I am inhaling the existence, the harmony, and exhaling this harmony in the form of words, in the form of energy. This is subtle. When Leon Leifold, who wrote the biography of Gurdjieff, he was curious to know about the life of George Ivanovich Gurdjieff. He went to the Middle East to meet the masters of Gurdjieff. One of them, he asked when he met, "What did you teach Gurdjieff?" He said, "I taught him how to breathe." "Breathe? What do you mean? How to breathe? We all breathe, but we do not know how to breathe." When in Islamic tradition, we are asked to do a particular kalma, it is not the word that is important. It is an exercise in the art of inhaling and exhaling. You are inhaling Allah and exhaling the Holy Prophet. And that is the kalma that we have to do in order to breathe with the existence. And when he breathes, the entire cosmos, the entire existence breathes with him. If you can learn how to inhale with the master and how to exhale too, if you can learn simply that, you have learned all. To breathe with the master is the way to transformation. Breathing with the master means you are flowing with his energy. Once you start flowing within his energy field, understanding comes. Life begins the process of transformation. For this very reason, the totality goes on manifesting in a myriad forms. The devil is the human being that has fallen from the height. God is the risen human being. God is the ultimate possibility of your beatitude, harmony and blessedness. And devil is the ultimate form. There is nobody like devil existing somewhere. You will never meet him unless you become him. And you will never encounter God unless you become an embodiment of godliness. Your mind acts as the devil when fallen from the glory and attains to godliness once again when attains to inner glory. The master therefore comes as your death and resurrection as well. And until this happens, man continues to live in reflections alone. Whatever we are is far from a reality, a mere reflection. When a lamp is lit, its shadow is always there. The shadow continues to follow the wheel. When you stand, the sunlight falls. A reflection is created. Your reflection is always longer than the actual image, such as human life that we have created around us. And then we seek happiness. How can you get happiness through reflections alone? Meditation and insights of the awakened one is the only way to go beyond such reflections, and then one day you discover your real face and eternal bliss. It is with this in mind, various series of talks began, and this wisdom from the sense of eternity is another series of talks that will incorporate many topics, questions and answers is the outcome of such an understanding. Topics like, when you come in the company of the Master, death happens. You die as you are and you are resurrected. The beginning of this process is called initiation. And when death is blissful, conscious, it becomes samadhi. And when death is relaxation, it is indeed the real relaxation. Deep within you surrender. You welcome the moment of annihilation. You have known life. And now you want to know death as well.